Hi there. I'm Leila.
And I'm Laura.
And this is For Your Penjoyment, a show about fountain pens and the joys they bring us.
Brought to you by Pen Boutique.
So how are you doing today, Laura?
Pretty good.
Yeah?
I slept until 2 again.
That is impressive. I have to say, once again, I am quite jealous.
Yeah.
This is a skill you're honing. I can tell.
It is. Guess what, Layla?
What's that, Laura? You're right. It's 2024.
It's 2024.
Happy New Year, everyone.
Happy New Year, except it's not really 2024. It's a big lie.
You're not supposed to tell them that, though.
But when I wrote in my notebook the notes for today, I accidentally wrote 1/27/24.
So not only did you skip ahead, you skipped ahead by a whole month.
Yeah.
What is time even?
It's a number.
Time is irrelevant.
Numbers completely meaningless for me.
I'm so sorry. So what pen are we using today, Laura?
Other than this one?
Other than the dip pen, that's right.
I was using my new Lamy All-Star.
It's beautiful.
In tourmaline.
Very nice.
Of course.
With the cursive nib.
And I have Astral from the Inkvet calendar in here, and it's so beautiful.
That's wonderful.
It's so gorgeous. It's like this amazing chameleon ink that's black, but when you tilt it, it's like green and gold, and ooh, I love it so much. And it flows really, really well with the cursive nib.
That was going to be my next question. Have you tested other shimmers in the cursive nib?
Yeah.
And you have no issues?
No, I like using them because I don't use shimmer inks that often.
Right.
But with my cursive nib, I like to use them.
That's inspiring.
And they behave very well, at least the ones that I've tried.
I might have to try that.
Yeah.
I've been very, careful with my cursive nibs, treating them very gently.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I will only stick to broads and stubs for my shimmers. Uh-huh. But if you're saying the cursive nib can handle it.
No. It works really well. It doesn't clog and it shows off the shimmer really well. And
I'm
love Astral. Astral's my favorite from the Inkvet calendar this
year. It was
year.
Gorgeous.
There's a lot of good ones, but that one's just really different. And
I like
really
Day 25, but I can't remember the name of it.
Raise a Glass.
Raise a Glass, that's the one.
It's really pretty, too.
That was lovely.
Yeah. What pen are you using, Layla?
I am actually using the pen that my office secret Santa gave me. This is from the Herbert Pen Company, based out of Virginia, I do believe. Mm. This was a limited run pen. It's number 40 out of 40.
Wow.
It was issued in spring of 2020. And my office secret Santa was kind enough to gift this to me.
Yeah. I couldn't believe it when I saw you open that because it's just so you. It's so pretty. Your secret Santa clearly knew what kind of pens you like.
She understood the assignment, that's for sure. So we've got some new and exciting things in store.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm excited about right now is the new Visconti limited edition Voyager Mariposa.
Oh, those are so beautiful. Yeah.
I mean, they're right in my wheelhouse. Yeah. They're swirly. The colors are gorgeous.
Uh-huh.
And I just think it's a beautiful homage to their original Voyager pen that was released in the 90s. And those colors. Let's take a look.
I got them in our show, Girolajo case.
That's right.
Staged up. So do you remember which color is which?
Yes.
Okay, so we have them in fountain and rollerball.
We have them in fountain and rollerball, that's right. So this color is
so
Painted Beauty. It's almost a steely blue with pink running throughout it.
Yeah, but it's got a mauve-y element too.
It certainly does.
It's super pretty. And it's got this amazing opalescence
shimmer.
Mm-hmm. Now this is a Jonathan Brooks material, right?
It certainly is, of the Carolina Pen Company.
Yeah.
It's gorgeous. Another winner, in my opinion.
Now, as you know, I don't usually like swirly pens very much, but I really do like this one. It's very, very beautiful and delicate looking.
Yes, delicate looking.
Yeah.
It's got this beautiful femininity to it that I appreciate.
The colors are just so soft and like different. It's not just like a boring blue or a boring pink. It's kind of an unusual shade.
And again, that opalescence that you were talking about makes it really special.
And let's take a look at malachite. Other color is just as beautiful. I can't decide which one I like better.
I think this might be my favorite color combination.
Okay. I don't know. I like both.
This one is called malachite. It's this beautiful like lime, almost chartreuse green. Again, with pink and black running through it. It has a similar opalescence to it.
And the pink color in both is, I think, the same color. Pink.
I think so.
Yeah.
It's somewhere between like a mauve and a baby pink.
Right. And this has some black in it, too.
Mm-hmm. The black makes it very striking, in my opinion.
Yeah, they're really interesting. And these are both inspired by butterflies.
Right. Mariposa in Spanish means butterfly. We've also got the new Otto Hoot Design 7s in this limited edition chocolate brown color.
Yeah, these are really different. This color. It's completely different from any of the other Otto Hoot pens.
It comes in a ballpoint.
Right. It's got a ballpoint. What do I have here? Roller.
And I've got the fountain. It's a very weighty pen.
It is very weighty.
I like how substantial it feels.
This, for me, would be a little bit too heavy. But a lot of people like weightier pens. But what I love most about this pen is the texture is really cool.
Yes.
It's this matte texture that, I don't know how to describe it, almost kind of like chalkboard feeling or something.
Right.
You rub your fingers over it and there's a little bit of drag and it's really enjoyable to touch. And it also has subtle ridges on it on both the barrel and the cap. And it's really, really enjoyable to touch. I really like that.
Like design wise, I just find it super pleasant.
Yeah.
Top to bottom.
Yeah.
Right.
And the top is cool. It's just flat with an OH on top. Logo.
Exactly. The metal components have a beautiful shine to them, which contrasts really well with the matte barrel and cap of
the pen. And the trim is this really interesting kind of brownish
color. Very reflective.
Color. Yeah. And it's just very, you know, a typical Otto Hoot thing where it's very streamlined and, you know, focus on form and very Bauhaus looking and just
understated.
Yeah. I really, really like it. It's nice.
Absolutely. Yeah. Next up is a favorite of ours.
Yeah.
We've got the Diplomat Arrow in a new color.
Sorry to zip while you were talking.
It's totally fine.
Yes. We both really like this pen.
Mm-hmm.
You own an Arrow, right?
I certainly
do. And I own an Elox, which is very similar to an Arrow. So, yeah, we both really like this new color, and it's totally different from any of their other ones.
Right.
Because the texture
the lacquer
is
finish.
Different.
This is lacquer white.
Yeah.
It's got a soft smoothness that the others strikingly do not have. It's a beautiful finish. It's got a slight shimmer to it.
It's kind of pearly looking.
Exactly.
I really like it. It's really pretty. It goes
it's
with
a great,
nails, too.
It does. It's a great addition to the Arrow family.
Yeah,
I'm super happy with it.
I like touching it. Again, it's got
super satisfying
something about it that's, you know, I don't want to say sensual, but
pleasant.
It's it appeals to the senses.
It certainly does.
It's So when we were looking at this pen, I just wanted to talk about some of our other favorite Arrows. Because I love this color, but this color was in our most recent Battle of the Pens.
Yes.
And a lot of people said they love this color and that they want to buy one in this color or that they voted for it because they love this color so much. So this is the, what's this one called?
Violet.
Violet.
We had a big Diplomat restock recently. So I'm glad
I really love that color. The shade of purple is really cool.
It's
kind of different, I really, really like it.
Definitely. What are some of our other favorite colors?
Another favorite. This one caught my attention because I love the name so much. The color name is Factory.
This is the particular Diplomat Arrow that I have. I love Factory. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. So I have factory inked with Sherwood Green from Diamond. And I call it my Oscar the Grouch pen.
Yep.
Because this, we've decided, looks like a trash can in this particular color. And that's delightful to me. So I call him Oscar, and he's great.
It does look like a trash can, but in a really adorable, a cool way. A cool way that makes me love it even more. It's not like, ugh, an insult. It's I love that about the pen. Another really pretty color that this pen comes in is Flame.
Flame has such a cool finish to it.
Yeah.
It's really unique.
It's got, what? It's like purple and orange and gold. Mm-hmm. It kind of goes with this shirt I'm wearing.
It kind of goes with your shirt, yeah, definitely. It's got like a deep red.
Yeah. That and none of the other ones are multicolored like this.
Exactly.
It's really interesting. It's really cool. And then another one that we both really like, and this one's very popular.
Is the
Antique Rose.
Antique Rose, that's right.
It's such a nice, soft, almost mauve-y rose color.
Exactly.
And it does look kind of old-fashioned.
For all you rose gold lovers out there, this really hits the spot.
It's a nice one.
Absolutely.
I'd say those are my favorites, but I like that pen in general, and I like that it comes in so many different interesting colors. Same. There's other interesting colors, too. We can have them all, but
absolutely.
And it writes really well, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like the way mine writes.
It's a great writer. Mine's super consistent, no hard starts. Like, I'm
very
happy
smooth.
With it. And then last on what's new in store, we've got some ink for you. We've got this Robert Oster Elements collection. He put out Earth, Fire, Wind, and Water. Mm-hmm. And I'm impressed by Water. Yeah, specifically.
You got really excited when you swatched Water.
It's a very unique blue, and the shimmer in it is gorgeous. It is the only shimmer ink in this collection. And
Water was the shimmer. It's got this blue shimmer.
And we'll post the swatches as a still in the video. Yeah. But it was really stunning.
What's Wind look like?
Wind is like a softer sky blue.
Okay.
Earth is this interesting brown with a green, green shading to it.
At first I thought I didn't like it, but then I was like, this is kind of a cool color, actually. And it's different.
It's a different brown.
I can't think of any browns that are exactly like this color.
Neither can I.
Yeah.
And then we've got Fire, which is this beautiful yellow. Also with, when written like with a wider nib, a broader nib, has an interesting like orange shading.
Yeah, nice
to it.
Shading on that one. Yeah, so those are cool.
Yeah.
And I noticed just now that the Water kind of goes with the same color as this pen we were just talking about.
Water
the
would be a beautiful pairing with the Visconti.
I don't know if you want to put a shimmer ink in your Visconti, but that'd it does match really well.
Super brave, but I think if you're a shimmer person, along with your swirly pen, it'd be the perfect combination.
Yeah.
Now, last week, we actually posted a short on YouTube and a reel on Instagram asking for your questions. We wanted to do a little Q&A video, and we thought that would be an interesting touch. And boy, howdy, did you folks deliver.
Yes.
So we've got a hatful of questions. We're going to draw them and answer as many as we can before we get exhausted. And we'll save the rest of the questions for future episodes, of course. Hopefully there will be no stomping.
That's right. I was going to remind you. I threatened to rip them up and stomp on them if there were any questions we didn't like.
I would never forget a threat like that. So without further ado, I'm going to pull the first question. Interesting. This is from Anna VZ5473. I do believe that was on YouTube. As you look back over your relationship with your pens and inks, what has stood the test of time?
Ooh.
That's a fun question.
Huh.
What do you think has stood the test of time in your relationship with pen and ink?
Waterman Tender Purple.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely leaps to mind for me.
Sure. For me, it's just still having a love of color for both my writing instruments and the inks I put them in. I admittedly don't own a single black ink, and that's my choice. I don't work in the medical field anymore. I'm not in academia anymore. I don't have to be legible if I don't want to be. So shimmers and brights it is.
Mm-hmm. Another one that leaps to mind for me is Waterman-inspired blue, another Waterman Ooh. Ink. I have had that ink in the same pen for, I don't know how many years. Like, how long have I been a fountain pen fan?
Quite a while.
Okay, so I've been a fan for about 5 years, right? Mm-hmm. I've had that ink probably in the same pen for about 4 years, and it's, I love it. I always love it. It always behaves perfectly. Mm-hmm. It's such a beautiful color. It brings me joy because it's cheerful and bright and vivid. It's a wonderful, wonderful ink.
I love that. I
really like it. Rain. Pens-wise, wow, I don't know. I get excited about my new pens, mm-hmm. and then I use my new pens and neglect my old pens a little bit sometimes.
I hear that.
But it's not like I don't like my old pens anymore. They have stood the test of time. Mm-hmm. I just don't use them as much because I get more into my new pens.
Sure. We've got an Instagram comment from Left Page Leroy.
Okay.
What wet ink would you recommend using in dry writing pens?
Ooh, I've got an answer for that one.
I've heard Aurora Black is a good choice, but I'm interested in others.
I like to put Irishizuku inks in my dry writing pens.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
That was going to be my answer as well. They behave so well in a dry writing pen.
Yeah, the Pilot Irishizuku are just... Mm-hmm. I've had pens that I'm like, ugh, this pen's not writing well. It's really annoying. And then I'll put one of those pens inks in and it'll be... Yeah.
Glides right through.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hugger Bear on Instagram.
Okay.
How many takes of these videos do you have to get through them? Do you have to do to get through them?
Specifically the one that we had all the outtakes.
We had some outtakes. There is an episode out there that we call the Lost Episode. It was an original taping that I scrapped because it did not spark joy.
Mm-hmm.
There are times in which... we will record something like the last episode, and then in trying to edit it, I'm stunted, and the reason for that is because it does nothing for me. So I will, contact Laura in a pinch. I'm like, can we please re-record this? Do you trust me?
Right.
And
I always have so far.
You certainly have. Yeah. And I think we've done really well with that. So let's say on average, like 2 takes.
Yeah, and often when we're doing the Battle of the Pens,
mm-hmm.
we'll do a take, and then we'll be like, yeah, that was pretty good, but we want a little more energy in it, so we'll record it again, and we like the second take better, usually, and we'll use that.
Definitely.
But it's not like we have to do a zillion takes.
No,
We don't usually, like, crack up and mess it up, except when we were recording that thing to try to solicit the questions. I just kept cracking up. I was in a very, very silly mood that day.
We got another YouTube comment from Hoyt Roberson.
Okay.
How many fountain pens do you have inked on any given day? Why that number? Are they for different purposes during the day? This is an embarrassing question for me.
Me too.
I have an abundance of inked pens right now, and maybe only 50% of them serve some kind of purpose. I'm, on average, carrying 5 pens on me at any given time. Okay. And then I get home, and then I'm writing, I'm editing. I have a specific method that I employ when I'm editing my first drafts.
Cool.
So I want to say the number, but I'm embarrassed by the number.
Say it.
Like 23 inked pens right now.
I just looked on my fountain pen companion thing where I keep track of how many, and I currently have 22 inked pens.
On Instagram, we have gail.weld. What do you use to carry your pens?
Okay.
What paper do you recommend? And third, I'm a beginner. What do I start off using to achieve great skill?
Great skill.
Great skill.
Wow.
That's an interesting question.
That is interesting. So what was the first part of the question?
What do you use to carry your pens in?
Okay. What do you use?
So I use two things when I'm carrying out and about. First is my Puni Labo case. Mm-hmm. It sits upright in my purse, so they're stored nicely. It's very cute.
Yes.
I can't go without cute in my life. And then if I need to transport...
But Leila, you have me.
You enhance the cuteness in my life, Laura. And then if I have to go anywhere with more than the 5 to 6 pens I carry in my Puni Labo, I've got the Girolojo pen case to transport. I have the 12 pen case. It satisfies that need. It'll get the job done for today's silly segment. Mm-hmm. So I'm quite content with that. Mm-hmm. What about you?
So I've got a few different things that I use. I have an Esterbrook to-go cup, which I like if I want a few pens, not too many, and something that won't, like, take up a lot of space.
Sure.
I'll just chuck it in my... I use, like, a little mini backpack a lot of times instead of a purse kind of thing, and I'll just throw it in there. So I like that. I also have a 24-pen Girolojo case that I like a lot. Was this for... She said for storage or for carrying?
I'm sorry. I'm forgetting the question already. Carry.
Carry. Okay. I don't usually use that one for carrying. I usually use it at home to store my pens in just because that's what I use it for.
Sure.
I also like to use the Yak Leather just flat pen sleeves that we have if I want to just bring one pen with me because it doesn't take up much space and it covers the whole pen. They're nice. And I also have a Yak Leather case. I use this when I'm working on my blog and I need to take pens outside to take pictures of them out in nature. And, you know, and because it's very sturdy and I can fit a lot of pens in there. And, yeah, I like that a lot. It's like I don't have to worry about it getting dirty if I set it down on the ground or stuff like that.
And then part two to the question, what paper do you recommend? What paper do you recommend?
That's a good one.
That's a good one. I think we've tried, between the two of us, we for sure have tried out every notebook in the store.
Yeah, probably.
Probably.
Yeah.
I like trying things out before I recommend them to anyone else. Just adds the authenticity of the experience. I don't want to say, hey, this is great, when I think the product is crap.
Right.
Write brand notepads.
I really like Write, too. I use one for the show.
Mm-hmm.
I use the meeting notebook for show stuff just because I like the layout for that.
Absolutely.
But I like all of their notebooks.
They're great.
I like the feel of the paper and how sturdy they are, how they have this, like, heavy cardboard on the back.
It just feels nice and protected.
Yeah, you could, like, be standing up and use it.
Mm-hmm.
I have a reporter's... Is that what it's called?
Yeah,
no,
the ledger.
The ledger, which is small.
Mm-hmm.
And I have that in my bag all the time.
Yeah.
And I just pull that out and write random stuff on it.
I haven't had any feathering issues with that brand of paper. I quite like it.
And I really like that it's a local brand from Baltimore, which is cool.
That's a nice detail.
Yeah.
I like a good hometown hero.
Mm-hmm.
Other brands, I'm currently using an Oasis notebook.
I like them too.
I have not had a problem with these notebooks. Maybe a little ghosting, but it's only a little.
Mm-hmm.
I'm quite happy with it otherwise.
I like the interesting lines in those. Like if you want to practice your handwriting, you can intentionally line it up with the little subtle lines, but if you don't want to, you can kind of ignore them because they're really light.
Right. It's super versatile. You can either use it as a dot grid notepad or graph paper or lined. Like like Laura was saying, they have subtle lines and dots in each page that makes it customizable,
and
which I love.
The Nemesine that you mentioned, I use one of those as my everyday one in the store where I just write down random stuff.
Same.
I really like the paper and the way my inks look on it and that it's spiral and it's not overly expensive, so you can just, you know.
Price point is very good for those.
Those are great.
And then, of course, you have Claire Fontaine and Rodeo.
Mm-hmm.
Those, I feel like there's been so much discussion around them that we don't really need to add to the conversation.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's solid, reliable paper.
Yep.
And then third question, I'm a beginner. What do I start off using to achieve great skill? Where would you begin?
I mean, my gut reaction when I heard that question was, you don't need great skill to use a fountain pen. Just
have desire.
Fun with it.
Exactly.
Who cares if your handwriting looks bad? Yeah, it's great if you can improve it, and that's something that you want to do. But
sure.
Don't be afraid to use a fountain pen because you have bad handwriting or whatever. It's not something that really requires skill. It's just adds enjoyment to your life by using a special pen.
Exactly.
And shouldn't be scared of it or feel like you need a certain level of ability to use it.
And if you're hesitant to jump right in, just send us another message. We'd be happy to talk you through it. Mm-hmm. Okay? We got another question from Hoyt Roberts, Roberson. Do you color match your pens and inks? If so, which combination has been your favorite so far?
Ooh.
Yes.
You definitely
do. The short answer is yes. I love matching my pens and inks. Mm-hmm. I can't help it. I recently got the Sailor Ringless Galaxy and Crab Nebula, and I matched it perfectly with a Sailor Ink Studio ink with the help of Laura. We scoured the book to try to find that perfect match.
Do you remember the number, or should we look it up later?
We can look it up later and post a swatch of it. Why not? But it just, it's such a good match. It's so satisfying. Yeah. It's so satisfying. What about you?
I don't usually match mine. Sometimes I do. Like the pen that I put, the Inspired Blue by Waterman, is a turquoise blue pen.
Ooh.
Or soft blue, it's called. It's a Pilot Prera in the color soft blue. And I really like the combo. But a lot of my pens, honestly, are black. So I don't need to match them color-wise. I do it more like personality-wise, I think.
Yeah. I can appreciate that. Our man, Hoyt Roberson, at it again. This is from YouTube. When cleaning your fountain pens, do you use pen flush or just water? If you normally use just water, what conditions of the pen would cause you to use pen flush?
That's a good question.
It's a solid question right there. What do you do?
I normally just use room temperature water.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I'll put like a drop of soap in it and then rinse it thoroughly afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
If I have a lot of trouble getting the ink out of the pen, then I will use pen flush.
Yes, same.
And I use it straight. I'll put it in like a really small vial, like the kind of vial you use for ink samples.
Yeah.
And I'll suck it up into the pen or even soak the nib section in the flush for a little while. If I have a lot of trouble getting it clean.
I have one of those suction bulb.
Yeah, I always use one of those.
Always use one of those. Yeah. How I know I will have done a good job is I can get the water running clear consistently after several pumps through.
Yeah.
But recently got myself an ultrasonic cleaner for home.
Ooh, nice.
It was steeply discounted, so I needed to have it, considering how many pens I have inked and probably shouldn't. I should go on a cleaning spree.
Yeah.
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 Last question. Let's make it count.
We have a lot left for a future episode.
We certainly do. Our dude... Hoyt Roberson.
Hey, don't forget, we said we would give a free bottle of ink to someone.
We certainly
and
did.
And I think Mr. Hoyt Roberson deserves one.
I think Hoyt Roberson earned his bottle.
About how many questions?
20 maybe? I can't recall.
He sent us a lot. And there were a lot of really good ones in there. Thank you so much. We really appreciate your questions.
So our last question, if you had to only use one brand of ink, which would it be and why?
What the heck? Ooh. We didn't put this in the rip up and throw on the floor and
stomp. We're not stomping on this. This is a serious question. This is the most serious one in my opinion.
Oh my gosh. One brand of ink?
One brand of ink.
Only one. I can't do two.
No, you can't do two.
Oh, come on.
I mean, I would allow you to do two, but I don't think Mr. Hoyt Roberson.
Mr. Hoyt won't let me.
Exactly.
How come I have to answer first?
I'm struggling to answer as well. I mean, for me, color range is very important.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking either Daimin or the Pilot Orochizuku.
I mean, my first reaction would be Pilot Orochizuku.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't have that many colors.
They don't.
And I love color.
Yes.
I'm tempted to choose Sailor because there's so many colors.
Different lines. Oh, my goodness.
But
yes.
But Sailor inks don't get along that well with some of my Pilot pens.
Same.
And I have a lot of Pilot pens.
Mm-hmm.
I
this is a real, like, Sophie's Choice kind of question.
I want to stomp on this.
You know what? Go ahead. Stomp on it. It's yours to stomp. All right, folks. Welcome to the silly segment. Today, we are going to blindfoldedly try to guess the pens in our own collection.
Very frightened.
You shouldn't be frightened. This will be fine. So what we're going to do, we're going to have Laura put on a blindfold.
Yes.
Go for it.
I brought my Metropolitan Opera scarf to do this with.
It's a gorgeous scarf.
I'm going to put my mug over here so I don't flail around and spill it while blindfolded.
I think that's a grand idea.
Okay.
Now, Laura has provided me with 12 pens from her collection. I am going to select 3 pens to give to her to see if she can identify them, just based on touch.
How does that look?
You look gorgeous.
I can't see anything.
All right, that's the point. Here we go. First one, I'm going to try to give you an easy one. Hold your hand out.
Oh, this one's easy. This is my Diplomat Ewoks.
Very nice. Right. Well done. I told you I was going to try to throw you a softball there.
All right, all right.
Now next.
Oh, my heart's pounding.
Open up your hand.
Is this more than 1 pound? I'm grabbing the wire of the microphone. Okay. Huh. Okay, it's pointy on the top. It's very smooth. It's very lightweight. What the heck is this? You're not tricking me, are you?
Nope. This is all you.
Okay, I think this is, I'm afraid I'm going to get it wrong. I think this is my Royal Tangerine Sailor 1911.
The fact that you even guessed the color is impressive.
Is that right?
You did well. All right, last up. Oh, there goes my pen falling to the floor.
All right.
Last but certainly not least.
Okay, this one's a pelican.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is hard. Oh no.
Now, remember, you are blindfolded. You do not have to guess the color. You can tell me the model, and I'd be perfectly satisfied.
They're all different models. I think it's my... I think it's my M205 Petrol Marble.
It certainly is.
Goodness.
All right, you can untie your blindfold. You have won the challenge.
Yeah. was hard because I had three pelicans in there.
I know you did. Oh,
and two were the exact same size.
You have three pelicans, two sails. You have a fun collection.
I tried to make it hard. Yeah. I didn't want to put in pens that were extremely different from each other.
See, that's all my collection is.
Oh. Are you sure this isn't the scary segment, not the silly segment?
Considering there's no consequence to getting this wrong, I don't know how this is quite the scary
segment.
Come
on, I know Gary from Pelican is watching this. If I got that wrong, I'd be so embarrassed.
Oh, God. All right. Hair looks a hot mess. I am ready to go.
Oh, you look great.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, there you are.
Oh, crap. I might not actually know this. No, wait.
You do.
Wait a second.
Use your senses.
Feels small. No, it's not small. Is it my Twisby Diamond 580 in Iris?
Yes, it is.
Very nice.
Good job.
Right, I'll put that right there.
Okay.
This is tough.
Okay. Ready?
Yep.
This is a hard one, but I have faith in you.
This is Rangoli.
Yes, you got that quickly.
Leonardo's got that point.
The pointy top.
Uh-huh.
Okay, very right. Good.
Okay. So, yep. Sailor 1911, Ellen Wicked Witch.
Yes.
That was a hard one because Ringless Galaxy feels exactly like that, except
it's
for the ring.
Ringless.
That's
though.
Right.
I know.
All right.
Very good. You were a lot faster than I was.
Well, we know our pen collection. I think you agonized a little more than I did.
I did. And I intentionally put ones in that were very similar to each other to make it hard for myself. I was more nervous about getting it wrong.
I mean, what would I have done? The hose. The beatings will continue until morale improves. Oh, no.
Now you have your glasses off. It's so disconcerting.
It's so strange. That's it for our episode, folks. Happy New Year once again. Be well. Keep writing. And we'll see you next time. As Laura switches up.
And don't forget to like and subscribe and all that stuff.
Thank you very much. That's the part I always forget.
I know. Me too, but then I remember it the last second. See you next time.